Alrighty, welcome to another Lost Caverns of Ixalan draft here on channelfireball.com. This draft is brought to you by Spyglass Siren and Ultimate Guard, sponsor of Team CFP. I do think Spyglass Siren is excellent, though. One mana, one on flyer is already like just kind of good for this format. The one drops are awesome. This also makes a map, so it's often just a 2-2 or draws you a land. Really good card. I'll take it over Restless Prairie. Diamond Pickaxe is also quite good, but I think I like Siren more, and I'd rather start blue than red, though both are excellent. It's also an Iceberg and a Pirates, which might come back. Passing, Deathcap Marionette, Hotfoot Gnome, yeah, a bunch of other cards that I'm not super stoked about. Oh, look at this. Nikanzeel, Current Conductor. Oh, this is an unfortunate part of this format. So this is a blue-green signpost uncommon build around that pays you off for exploring, and I just took a good explore uncommon. So, should I take this? The answer is no. The answer is I should just take Waterwind Scout. 3-mana 2-2 flying makes a map token because blue-green is just not a good color combination. Rarely is in Modern Limited. They just kind of haven't cracked the code on how to make that good. And I'd rather just take another good blue card. Plus, the blue-green explore deck, just that also doesn't come together, which is part of why blue-green isn't good. It's kind of like chicken and the egg. In any case, I'm just going to take Waterwind Scout and be very happy with it. Third pick. All right, here we are. Goblin Tomb Raider, Saheeli's Lattice. Not an Ixalis Lorekeeper deck. This is for dinosaurs, which is not in the blue-green theme. If I wanted to take a mono-blue card, I could just take Waylaying Pirates. 4-mana, 3-3, it stuns a creature. But I think blue-red is a very good deck. I mean, it is a very good deck. It's not even just I think. And there's two really good red commons here. Itali's Favor is very good on these things. Goblin Tomb Raider is just great in general in these like low curve aggro decks. And I think I'm just going to take the Tomb Raider. Sadly, I don't think the black removal spell is good. In this format, casting removal spells is generally not the way. Like if I'm playing these creatures and my opponent has cards like this in their deck, it's just not that good for them. The creatures are cheap. They provide value. I'm going to take Tomb Raider here. Oh, and now we get a Diamond Pickaxe. I actually like this more than a Tomb Raider here. Maybe I'll wheel this, though probably not. 1-mana, indestructible artifact, but mostly it's that it makes treasures whenever you attack, and I've got all these cheap creatures to attack with, and it also gives +1/+1, so very happy to pick that up. And follow it up with probably an Volatile Wanderglyph. I've also been really impressed with this card. 2-mana 2-2 artifact is already kind of nice, right? You've got your like Goblin Tomb Raider and other cards that care about artifacts. And whenever it becomes tapped, you get to rummage, which helps with Descend. It also just helps smooth out your draws. So I like that more than Idol of the Deep King. Again, paying 3-mana to remove a card that costs 1 or 2 mana is just not a good deal. Orozca Puzzle Door is playable, but not something I'm really that gonna prioritize that much. Once you have a bunch of Oaken Sirens, the 2-mana 1-2 flyer that taps for blue mana, but you can only spend it on artifacts, then the Puzzle Doors get better. But I'm going to start with getting the Oaken Sirens first, because those are also a great card, which I would be thrilled to pick up. Currently, we've got a really good start. 2 1-drop creatures, an equipment, a nice 2-drop creature, and a really good 3-drop creature. So we've got the blue-red aggro deck start, which is kind of what you want here. Oh, and now we get to pick up an Inverted Iceberg. Another really good card. It's 2-mana cantrip, right? You mill one, you draw one, doesn't do anything else besides sit and play as an artifact. Then at some point, you just get to cast a 6-6 for free, like, because you get to craft out of your graveyard and you already got a card back out of the iceberg. So it's kind of like a Colossal Dreadmaw that you get to cycle early, except you also get to cast the thing. It's very much like a land cycler. You're like, all right, I'll cycle this early, but then you still get to cast it late. So that's great. And passing up a bunch of green and black cards, unsurprisingly. Oh, another Tomb Raider, 7th pick. Ooh, this is shaping up to be a good one. And we've got, the only thing that would make this better is if I wheel the other Diamond Pickaxe. I don't think that's gonna happen. But with a 7th pick Goblin Tomb Raider, you never know. If I end up with all the Goblin Tomb Raiders I saw on this pack, then our deck is gonna be amazing. And I really like the start. We've got a bunch of cheap creatures. We've got some good artifact count already. We've already got 3 artifacts plus the 2 merfolk that make, or this is actually not a merfolk, right? This is just a pirate, the Spyglass Siren. Yeah. The 2 cards that make map tokens. So really 5 artifacts right now because you get that one for free. Not a big Relics Roar fan. It's fine. Don't really want a 5-drop. I think I will take Brazen Blade Master. 3 mana 2/3, but if you have two artifacts when you attack, it's a 4/4. And I don't think that the caves are very good in these decks. Ancestor's Aid is also okay, but I think I'd rather just take the Blade Master just to make sure I have another good creature. I don't want a lot of 3-mana cards. I'd rather have 1 and 2-mana ones, but having 2 so far after pack 1 is not too bad. Waylaying Pirates came back. So did Cartographer's Companion and Hotfoot Gnome. Okay. Yeah, at the cost of getting a little expensive, I think I still will take Waylaying Pirates over Cartographer's Companion. And then I don't really want Didact Echo or Sorcerer's Spyglass. Boulder's good for like Descend decks, but I don't think it's very good here. I guess I'll take the Blowgun. No, I'll just take the Didact Echo to cut blue, even though I don't really plan on playing it. And see what else I can get. Could still use, you know, we want to up our artifact count. Burning Sun's Cavalry. 2 mana 2/2. You have to have a dinosaur to make it bigger, which I don't have any yet. But I'll take it partially to cut off red cards. And 4 mana and 5 mana artifacts aren't really what I'm looking for. Oh, another Wailing Pirate. Okay. So happy enough with this. The first half of the pack was amazing. The second half was fine too. I mean, obviously it gets worse as the pack goes on. But I think that besides the fact that we didn't get any Tomb Raiders or Pickaxes back, which we shouldn't, those are premium cards, things look pretty good though. Black and white both seem very open. Those cards are both pretty good. All right, what do we got here? Oh, this card is disgusting. I'm not going to be able to take it, unfortunately, but 3 mana 2/4 Death Touch, and when it attacks, you get a vampire token with lifelink or draw a card and lose a life, or both if both players are tied. Obscene. Yeah, I'm still just going to take Atali's Favor. Like, we've got a really good blue-red deck going here. There's no reason to take a black card or a red-green card. These are both very good. All right, well, sometimes you don't open the rares and the colors that you are, unfortunately. Oh, wow, now there's Bitter Triumph, Clay-Fired Bricks, like all these great black-white cards, which, yeah, those colors are open. Do I want the third Pirates or a Hotfoot Gnome? I'm kind of worried about my artifact count, so let's just take the Gnome here. And the other Pirates have been wheeling anyway. Okay, and this is more like it. So now there's Dowsing Device, which I actually really do like if you're heavy enough on artifacts. Whenever an artifact enters the battlefield, one of your creatures gets +1/+0 in haste. And then if you have 4 artifacts, this turns into a land that then pumps a creature by a lot. There's also Enterprising Scallywag, which is descend, make a treasure token. And I'm not going to take it here, but I would love Cogwork Wrestler in this deck. I just think the red uncommons are better. So currently I've got 4 artifacts, but really 6 because the 2 creatures that make them. But I'm shaping up to have a lot. I kind of just want Dowsing Device here, though. I guess in this aggro deck, no. They both make artifacts. I'm just going to take the Scallywag. Scallywag, I think, is pretty good. Okay, so now there's Council of Echoes. If you have Descend 4, it's a 6/6 flyer to bounce something. But this really isn't a that deck. I think I'm just going to take Shipwreck Sentry. A 2-mana 3/3 Pirate can only attack if you have artifacts. I don't really want Rumbling Rock Slide. Oh, and there's Oaken Siren, yeah. I like that over Inverted Iceberg. Just this taps for mana. It just makes everything work so much more nicely. Also makes things like Pirate Hat, which I'm actually very interested in coming back. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, there's a chance this is one of the last cards in this pack because it would be excellent here. And then now Puzzle Door, because I really just want to up my artifact count. Puzzle Door also helps with Descend for Scallywag, which is nice. All right. This pack is certainly less good than the first one, but, you know, picking up some decent stuff here. Oh, another Atali's Favor. These do actually work pretty well in multiples. You give a creature +1/+1 trample and discover 3. The drawback in this deck is that the curve has a lot of one drops, but Atali's Favor is still pretty good. It's at its best in like a red-green deck that doesn't have quite as low of a curve. But part of the reason I also like Oaken Sentry is you put Atali's Favor on this, just cracking for 2 in the air. That's just pretty good. And every time you Atali's Favor into like a 3 drop, it's just so good. Definitely underrated that one in the set review initially. I mean, we already have 17 playables, 6 artifacts, really 8. Okay. Oh, there's Pirate Hat. Waterlogged Hulk is good in the Descend deck. It's pretty bad in this deck. It's a 1-mana artifact and you can turn it into a vehicle, but Pirate Hat is pretty nice on like just the cheap creatures. So I think I'll just take the hat. I don't really want a four drop that ramps me. That's just not what we're into. So looking for more Oak and Sirens. Obviously Tomb Raiders would be fine. Want some more artifacts. Guess I'm really not playing any of these cards, so it doesn't matter. No Runaway Boulders. Bitter Triumph Wield? I mean, black isn't that good, so I guess I understand. I'll take Buried Treasure, which I'm also not going to play. Oh, I might actually play another Shipwreck Sentry. And Pirate Hat didn't wheel, funny. I'll take Council of Echoes here, though I don't think I'm going to play that either. It's just a 6-mana card. It's not really what I'm looking for. Oh, Pirate Hat did wheel, sorry. Oh, along with the Lava Tongue. Wow. Well, double Pirate Hat with double Sentry is pretty nice. That's actually a pretty good 2-3 curve. Turn 2 Sentry, turn 3 Hat equipped because it's a pirate. You get to attack for 4 and loot. What do I not like here? I guess I wouldn't mind if I got to cut the Hotfoot Gnomes. Ended up getting another not wheeling the Wailing Pirates, but that's fine. Sure, whatever. If the person next to me isn't drafting black, then I don't know what I can do to help them. And right now, this is 9 artifacts. Yeah, that's looking pretty good. If I end up with like 12, 13 artifacts, I'll be happy. And no one wants the Slow Descend cards. All right, where are the red and blue cards? We didn't open any, huh? That's cool. Yeah, there's no playables here for me. Well, I mean, I guess I could take Ancestor's Aid, but that's just really, it makes a treasure, I guess, but it's really not good. I just don't think I need it. I have double Pirate Hat. I just want creatures and whatever. I'll just take a Pugnacious Hammer Skull for vault progress. I don't know. Sometimes you just miss on packs. It's fine. Ooh, the Belligerent. 4-mana, 5/5 vehicle. When it attacks, you make a treasure token, and you can just play cards off the top of your deck there till the rest of the turn. Yeah, I'll be taking that. That looks great for this deck. Good for a low curve deck, passing a Wander Glyph and another Pirates. And follow it up with, I guess I'll just take Plundering Pirate. One thing I like about Plundering Pirate is with double Itali's Favor, having high impact 3 drops to hit is pretty nice. And this helps. It can crew the Belligerent and gives you treasures to play with them. Obviously, it's not really what I want to be like third picking, but this deck is looking pretty good already. Its interaction is double Wailing Pirates pretty much and just attacking the opponent. I think that's actually a fine way to go about things. Could use more Oak and Sirens. Oak and Siren into turn 3 Belligerent. Ooh. All right. I will just keep taking Atali's Favors though, because that also stacks very nicely. So we've got enough threes now. We really need to find just another good 2-drop creature. Though I guess Shipwreck Sentry into Atali's Favor is kind of funny. It's like you go Sentry, Favor, and you're just like hope to hit an artifact in order to get the attack that turn. That would be pretty nice. Yeah, besides like Oaken Siren or other like 1/2 mana creatures, I'm feeling pretty good. I mean, this is 22 cards already. Wouldn't mind playing like 17 land in a triple Atali's Favor deck, though I could see playing 16 as well. I don't really want another Pirate Hat. I guess I will just take another Plundering Pirate, but that's not the spot in the curve I'm looking to fill. I have way too many 3-drops now. Maybe this Brazen Blade Master has to go. I mean, I like the Blade Master, but I think Pirate's going to be more reliably good, and upping the artifact count is pretty important. Because like Shipwreck Sentry into Plundering Pirate is a much better curve than into Brazen Blade Master. I will say that. All right, we're just going to keep taking Atali's Favors. Sorry, Shipwreck Sentry. Look, we're going to have the double or triple Atali's Favor turn sometime, and it's going to be really good. So this is 23. So if I get another card, I need to cut something. And I don't know what that card would most likely be. Because I don't really want to cut any artifacts. I have 10 if you count the 12 if you count the Plundering Pirates. Yeah, that's actually a pretty good count. Especially since I would argue that Atali's Favor has to count as some part of an artifact. Because you hit an artifact so often. Okay. So now it's Inverted Iceberg versus Sunfire Torch. It's actually pretty close. I kind of like Iceberg because I feel like with double Pirates, I'm going to get up to enough mana to cast them. But Torch is a little bit of interaction, and I already have an Inverted Iceberg. Let's just go with the torch here, I think. I think that's right. And I would like to play 17 lands. Let's see if I get anything else. Gold Fury Strider, I guess I'll take, but I'm not really going to play this card. I just don't need another expensive card. The Belligerent being the top of your curve is actually really nice. I'll just take whatever. Do I cut Puzzle Door for the torch? I guess I don't have tons of ones, but Puzzle Itali's favor into Puzzle Door is pretty disappointing, though I guess hitting torch is also kind of whatever. Okay, just whatever. No, we're not getting any more playables here. I think that's pretty clear. Oh, another Pirate Hat and another Waylaying Pirates. Well, I'm not going to play a third Pirate Hat, so I'll take the Pirates, but I don't really think I'm supposed to play three Waylaying Pirates either. It feels like my curve would just be too high at that point. I could also run 16 land. It's not crazy. My curve is pretty low, even with all those Itali's favors. Like, let's take a look here. Like, it's just going to tell me to play 8-8, and this would be 41, or 8-9. So if I did this, it'd be 8-8, all those 1-drops. Yeah, actually, I could play 16 land in this deck. Like, I've got so many 1 and 2 mana cards. All right, let's get into it. This deck looks like a lot of fun. And let's see how well this Itali's favor Pirate Brew does. Itali's favor into Plundering Pirate is pretty good. The only thing I really was missing is I could have just used another Oaken Siren, you know, as one does. Perfect hand. Turn 1, Tomb Raider. Turn 2, Pirate Hat. Turn 3, Scout or Itali's favor. Probably Scout, because I would want to put the Itali's favor onto the Waterwind Scout. Okay, Puzzle Door. Huh. I could play and use Puzzle Door instead. Is that better than playing Pirate Hat? No, I think playing Pirate Hat's better. The reason is this goes turn 3 Scout, and then turn 4 if I draw a land, I can equip the Pirate Hat and play Itali's favor. I think that's going to end up working out better. Oh. That's interesting. No, let's still play Waterwind Scout here, and let's attack. There's no way they trade here. And then play Waterwind Scout, and then this sets up next turn. Some combination of all these cards. I mean, maybe I play Itali's favor. If they leave mana up, I guess I'm probably not just slamming favor. Breaches Eager Pillager? Oh, jeez. They can attack and then make a treasure here. Or they could make it so my creature can't block. I guess I actually have to block there because Breaches is so sick when there's multiple pirates out. Yikes. 3-3 First Strike. Whenever a pirate you control attacks, you get to choose make a treasure, target creature can't block, or exile the top card. Yeah, I'm just going to lose to that, I guess. And it's one of the drawbacks of not having a ton of interaction. Also, this card's just a ridiculous card, too. I'm just going to go for Itali's favor. The problem is I probably can't attack after that. But I can't really attack otherwise. All right, let's just Itali's favor this and maybe hit something good. Maybe another Itali's favor. Yeah. All right. That's how you do it. Into another one? No, into a Shipwreck Sentry. But hitting the second Itali's favor means we do get to attack for 4. Yeah. I think I'm just going to try to race Breaches. I just don't think I can realistically try to block this because, look, they could just attack and make it so my creature can't block. Obviously, they're just going to get to make a treasure this way. But I think just taking the damage here and then next turn I have a Haster. This is going to get to attack too if I play either of those. 4-5 Reach? Okay. That does change things a bit. I guess I'm just gonna Pirate Hat the Tomb Raider so I can attack with just that and then loot. Discard an island. All right, you take 5 and let's go. I wanna play Siren. I think I'm gonna play everything but the Tomb Raider this turn. And I wanna use the map token, but I think I wanna use the map token. I guess I could have done this the other order, whatever. I'll use the map token on this. Plundering Pirate, I don't really want to draw that land. And then I think I just use the map token again on this. And Oaken Siren, okay, I don't want to draw that either. All right, this looks pretty good. I mean, if they didn't play Breaches, this game would have just been a landslide in my favor. But You know, because my draw is actually really sick, but oh, they're letting me block. Yeah, that's fine. I'll run into whatever trick they have here. I think it's gonna happen either way, and might as well make them do it now. And then the Tomb Raider still gets to attack, though. Now they gain three, and now they can double block. And they just played another 2/2. Sunfire Torch is unfortunately not gonna do it. Guess I play Puzzle Door and use it. What am I looking for? I mean, what I need to find is some waylaying pirates. If I attack, this trades for the Altisaur, basically. Well, yeah, because I don't want the Burning Sun Cavalry to get to block either. So let's do equip this. I can attack. Actually, I will attack with both. And then Sunfire Torch, the Burning Sun. And then I get to loot here. If it's a Waylaying Pirate, I'll take it. Diamond Pickaxe. I think I've got to keep the Puzzle Door. And I think I've got to keep the Tomb Raider. They double block, I kill the Altisaur. I mean, I'm pretty dead here either way. No, I'll discard the Tomb Raider. I'll use the Siren for my future plans. All right. And then I take two off the Altisaur. This trade. And I play Puzzle Door and pass. And I'm gonna sack Puzzle Door. I guess I'll just sack it now because I haven't played a land yet. So I don't really want to take a land, but if I do end up doing so. Yeah, still just take an iceberg. I would want to play the land this turn. Like if I hit a mountain and play the pickaxe, I think that would have actually been fine too. All right, now they're gonna exile their top card. Yeah, Breach is a six. Ooh, 3 mana, 6/6. All right, yeah, we're not gonna win this one. I mean, we just got soloed by Breaches. Breaches is a 3 mana, 3/3 first strike that just made a treasure every turn. It was a Fable of the Mirror Breaker token. And yeah, that wasn't great. All right. Well, starting out 0-1, but I still think this deck is awesome. So I'm still gonna predict that we get 5 wins. But we'll see, we'll see. At 0-0, I would have predicted 6 wins. At 0-1, I think 5 is a reasonable prediction. I just think this deck is very good. But we'll see how it plays out. I could be wrong. I could also be right and lose. That is also a possibility. Yeah. This deck. Or this hand would like to see a 2-drop, but even if I don't draw a 2-drop, I go Torch into Pirate Hat into Plundering Pirate. So I've used my mana every turn, and then I go Atali's Favor and equip everything. The hat, the torch, you know, everything get in there. All right, let's go turn on Sunfire Torch. Best draw, Oaken Siren, as usual. That would take Tomb Raider as well. Okay. Land isn't the plan, but them doing nothing isn't bad. And I don't think, I don't think I'm going to equip this turn with the treasure. Against Forest, it just really doesn't seem like what I should do, though. I guess Idol of the Deep King now could be bad. Okay. Whew. So they kept a green hand, drew their red. But they're playing a board or a card draw hand smoother card this turn. So that really is not too bad. Okay, let's start with Atali's Favor because that's going to inform kind of what we want to do otherwise. Atali's Favor into Shipwreck Sentry is fine. I'll get to attack with it next turn. And then Island. And I think I'm going to equip Pirate Hat here. Not going to equip the Torch because I want to use the treasure to flip this iceberg at some point here. Because I have a look, the thing is, I have a looting effect now, right? I have the Pirate Hat. So every excess land I keep is kind of costly. Interesting. Let's start with Inverted Iceberg. Because if we draw like a Waylaying Pirates, like the game just ends. No luck on that. They're gonna trade for the Plundering Pirate, I think. The question is, do I want to equip something on the Shipwreck Sentry to do a little bit more damage? I'm not going to want to spend mana next turn. I'm going to spend it this turn. Let's just attack. We'll loot. I can still discard a land here because I have that treasure. You trade for the 5-4, of course. Really? They must have a bunch of fight cards in hand. That's fine. Let's go Wanderglyph, land. Just play the Puzzle Door, I think. And pass. I guess I don't know what I'm going to craft with this yet. I assume I'll have an artifact that's dead at some point here. They have to have like Whatley's Final Strike in hand or something along those lines to take tons of damage and not block there. That very firmly indicates to me that they've got a really good reason to keep this thing in play. And now they're deciding what to fight with, but it's going to be tough. They're certainly not doing this. That would make no sense. Let's just take my turn. Waterwind Scout, huh? Yeah, maybe I don't flip the Iceberg this turn. Let's see. I can't attack with the Shipwreck Sentry currently. Let's just go Waterwind Scout. Sunfire Torch on the Wanderglyph. And then I get to attack with the Sentry now because I played the Scout. They're going to kill the Plundering Pirate before I get to attack with it, presumably. But then I get to attack with these two still, so that's totally fine. I suppose I could have moved. Yeah, there's Whatley's Final Strike. The Pirate Hat. I just didn't really think I needed to do that. Attack. And I don't think I need to sack the Puzzle Door here. The only advantage to sacking Puzzle Door now is that it would let me loot away the card I drew, but I don't think I'm going to want to do that anyway, so I think I'd rather just do this. Oh, and they have like the +3/+3 staggering size. Yeah, all right. I mean, again, there was a reason they kept their thing in play, even though it was pretty costly. So now I've got three different things I could do, basically. I could equip Torch, I could equip Pirate Hat, or I could use the Puzzle Door. I already have played a land this turn. Yeah, I think so. Or I could use a map token, actually. Let's use a map token on the Waterwind Scout here. The Belligerent. Yeah, that seems like a fine draw. I've got two things that can crew it. It's a pretty big threat. I'm at 20, so I also just like don't have to attack with Shipwreck Sentry and trade. I can just leave it back to crew the Belligerent. It kind of feels like my Waterwind Scout's about to get taken down, though. I also have a Wanderglyph in the graveyard, so I could flip Inverted Iceberg if I wanted. I think the Belligerent is going to be a better play than that. Oh, they're trading there? Rough way to go about it. That makes it really hard to imagine them winning. Yeah, let's just play the Belligerent, because if they kill the Shipwreck Sentry, I can make this a creature and crew the Belligerent that way. And let's equip the Pirate Hat on this instead of sacking the Puzzle Door. I'm not going to attack here. I don't want to trade when I could just be crewing this. Ooh, are we going to get to have a good Belligerent turn? That'll be sick. Scythe Claw Raptor, sure. They could craft that, but they have no dinosaurs in their graveyard, so it doesn't really make sense to do that. All right, let's crew this with a Shipwreck Sentry. Yeah, that's got to be better. I could crew that with a Iceberg, but I feel like, especially with a Puzzle Door out, just getting to play my whole turn is pretty nice. Kill the Menace one. I don't really care about playing spells on their turn. All right, play that. And now I've got a Puzzle Door to clear the top card. It probably was better just to... All right, not land. Oh, Atali's Favor. Probably just better to equip the Sunfire Torch, but I really just wanted to have a good turn here. All right, we're going to discover past that into a Plundering Pirate. Is that another Atali's Favor? Yes. All right, that's Atali's Favor, the Plundering Pirate. Discover an Enterprising Scallywag and hit another Atali's Favor that I can't quite use. I think that was a good enough turn, though. I make another token end of turn because something did descend, and now, I mean, we just have it all. It wasn't really necessary to go about it that way. Honestly, Equipping Torch was way better because it would trade for both their creatures, but I was just kind of excited to get to do all the things. And all right, we are 1-1. Alrighty, time for round three. I'm on the play, and I think the play is going to be Sentry in a Pirate Hat, but it is funny that it has come up here that we have the potential turn two Shipwreck Sentry, turn three Atali's Favor. Let's spin the wheel here, but that's not where we're at right now, so we'll see, we'll see. Oh, another Atali's Favor. Kind of wanted to be, that to be in the deck. So we get the favor into favor, but also drawing it is pretty decent. Let's see. They played a turn one blue-white tap land, creature land, sure. Into a forest and staunch crewmate. All right. Getting a Dusk Rose Reliquary. Wow. They've got some stuff going on here. Interesting. Let's go Pirate Hat. I like the idea here of Pirate Hat, equip pirate, attack, can loot away a land if I draw it. Sunfire Torch I kind of like. Let's get the Tomb Raider out of here, I think. Feels like I'll be happy enough. I don't know. Tomb Raider versus Shipwreck Sentry is kind of close. This being a little bigger, it feels like with all these, I'll be able to keep attacking with these already. Though Haste with Pirate Hat is also kind of nice, so let's see what we can do here. Another Staunch Crewmate. Look at you go. Into Orozca Puzzle Door. Okay. And it, no attacks. Okay, well, I'm going to go Atali's Favor on this. Play my land first so I can play Sunfire Torch into Atali's Favor. I don't actually really want to hit the dubs this time because they're going to Dusk Rose Reliquary it. Oh, but Scallywag isn't bad. All right. And I haven't played an artifact yet, so I'll play this. Send for six. Loot. Maybe now I discard the Shipwreck Sentry. So with a Pirate Hat now, I'm going to discard the Puzzle Door. Pirate Hat makes me want to keep the Sentry. I can just keep looting into artifacts is the plan here. And I make a treasure token. So they got to play this. They have to sack an artifact or creature. Okay. I mean, it's going to end up being a 2-for-1 in my favor because the Atali's Favor is paid for themselves already. And, oh, they milled a Self-Reflection. Look at you. And the Pirate Hat I can re-equip. Now they can play another Puzzle Door. Play this, sack, Puzzle Door. Yeah, get the Sentry out of here, that's fine. And then are they gonna make some attacks here? Or no, no attacks. So now, I could have Tali's Favor, but I kind of want to go equip, attack, and then sack the torch, and then torch one of the crewmates, and then now they can't block. I get a loot, and then they go to seven here. Oh, or they're chomping to save three damage. That also works for me. And then I play Shipwreck Sentry. End of turn, I descend because of the Sunfire Torch, and then now I've got plenty of mana, and I have Atali's Favor, kind of ready to go here. And we'll see what their play is, but I feel pretty good about the situation. They play a River Herald Guide, a 3-1. Sure. And they drew a cave. So they look like they're some kind of caves deck, that's for sure. All right, now I do want to hit. I guess I kind of want to put the favor on the Scallywag, because if I don't hit an artifact and can't attack, it's pretty bad. So let's just do that. I did hit an artifact, as it turns out, but it's still okay. Because now, yeah, they're dead. Well, they're not literally dead, but they're going to take four, trade there. I was going to get to loot. It was going to be pretty good times for me, I would say. And that brings us to 2-1. Let's see. Okay. Next game, Antonio. That's my brother's name. That I do not believe is my brother, though. He does play Magic, which is funny. All right. Yeah, no one drop here, and I'm on the draw. Those are two strikes against this hand, but turn two, Shipwreck Sentry. Oh, they mulligan, never mind. Well back in the driver's seat. Shipwreck Sentry has been really good in this deck. Sentry probably into Waterwind Scout attack, and then Atali's favor the Waterwind Scout, something like that. There's also a Plundering Pirate here. I'm going to play Sentry. I guess I would trade for Belligerent Yearling. My hand is really gassy, so it feels like not trading isn't a good idea. Buried Treasure, huh? Land, and yeah, let's go Waterwind Scout. I think I would rather have Itali's favor on the Scout, and at the very least, maybe treasure map it, or map it rather. Panicked Altasaur. Oh, 4/5. Okay. Oh, that's pretty good. That's really good. Waylaying Pirates. Tap the Altasaur. Smack for 2. They can discover 5 if they have a land. Or they just have a Poison Dart Frog. Okay, that's okay. Now it's Atali's favor time. I'll put it on the Waterwind Scout. Oh, are they going to braid me? Oh, that would be sick. They just have the frog, though. 3 drop. Oh, another Atali's favor. All right, let's put it on the Pirates this time. Into another Atali's favor. No, Puzzle Door. All right. That's fair. And I think I want to play the Shipwreck Sentry, not use the map. And I'm okay. I'll trade one of these for the Poison Dart Frog. They can pay 2 to give it Death Touch. Yep. That's fine. Okay. Oh, I don't mind that trade because now I'll play the Sentry here. This can become a 5/5 if I hit with the map token, which would make it go past the Panicked Altasaur, which is nice. And they play Caslim Stone Tree. That is a weak play. They just basically spent their whole turn getting a land into play, which is not an ideal scenario. All right. That's not good. Let's start with the Puzzle Door, I think. So I have more mana. Oh, another Atali's favor is fantastic. All right, maybe I should be mapping first. No, I'm just gonna put the favor on the Waylaying Pirates here. Yeah, I take back everything I said about Atali's favor. It is awesome. Oh, it would have worked better to map first. And then I actually will also map and explore land. Hit for 5 here. They're nugging me, then going down to 7. All right, now they can discover 5. Unfortunately, the exploring into a land after Puzzle Door into Goblin Tomb Raider has not looked fantastic. Oh, they get to kill my thing. Uh-oh. We need to find another Waylaying Pirates. That would win us the game. Mountain is not going to do it. Now we need, like, an inverted iceberg or something, because we are out of gas. They've got an Altasaur, and they're going to at the very least get to discover 5, if not something else. Another Altasaur. No. All right, draw another Tomb Raiders. Oh, so even if we had mapped in the other direction, it wouldn't have really changed much. I guess I'll play it. I mean, yeah, now we're kind of dead. I mean, we've drawn 9 lands so far, so we're just our cards are not quite as effective as theirs. All right. I give up. Panicked Altasaur does the thing, and there's another land. All right, 2-2. Felt like that game was we were pretty far ahead, and then things kind of just tapered down. Okay. Let's see what we can do here. Go 3-0? Go 5-0? We'll see. I'll do my best. Okay. The deuce bag, I see. And opponent goes first. Any creature, I've got four auras. Nice. Or a Goblin Tomb Raider away from having the god draw. Yeah, let's go ahead and keep this then. This hand I actually don't mind being on the draw. Let's do the pickaxe first. Plundering Pirate means I do have a turn four play. Okay, and the Poison Dart frog I can take out with the Sunfire Torch. All right, we're getting our gear ready. Our gear is getting ready. Let's see. They have all green and they're hitting for one. They're attacking with the Poison Dart Frog. Ooh, okay. Them taking a turn off is a pretty big game for me. Let's just play the Pirate. Now that we've gotten to this turn, obviously Scallywag last turn would have been amazing, but now that we're here, let's just play the Pirate. Let's not equip anything with the treasure. We don't need to do that. In the Presence of Ages, reveal the top four cards, put a creature and or a land. So they get a creature, but no land, and they're going to get Sentinel or Chupacabra. I guess they don't have double black for Chupacabra yet, but if they draw it, obviously that does the trick. So they took the Sentinel. Okay. That is fine. And they probably don't have other lands in hand at all. They must have just drawn the Swamp. You wouldn't lead on those three lands when you have Swamp in your deck, if that was the way. All right, they make a map token, and then they're going to make me exile a land. Okay, what to do? I'm going to equip the pickaxe, and I think equip the pirate hat. And really hope to draw a land here. As it turns out, I did actually want to draw a land. Let's discard the ice. Kind of a lot of mana. No, let's discard the iceberg. We're not getting there. All right, and then I already discarded an iceberg, so playing the Scallywag basically only costs one treasure because I get one back, which I think is well worth it. Okay, they get to attack with this and get another map token if they want. It's going to be Itali's favor time next turn. And maybe Sunfire Torch on the Poison Dart Frog at some point here. All right. Map token. Hit Mineshaft Spider. Is that good or bad for you? I mean, you might want to leave it on top because you can attack and get another map token and then use that map token to guaranteed. Yeah, they're going to leave it on top. Make that bigger. Okay, can't do anything about that. I'll take it. But Itali's favor is going to make this big enough to trade. I do kind of want to draw a land so I can... If I don't draw a land, I guess I... Man, I have to just like play Itali's favor and then next turn play Sunfire Torch. Okay, I did draw the land. So let's go land. Tali's favor on the pirate. All right, time for some big hits. No, I wouldn't call that a big hit. It's fine, whatever. Sunfire Torch. Equip on the pirate. All right, send. And I guess the loot from the pirate head is not going to be great. I will take action on the Sunfire Torch and bzzt the Poison Dart Frog. And then now they've got, I get another treasure. I've got to discard Itali's favor. I think Waylaying Pirates is going to be really good here. Because I'm assuming these are going to trade, and then next turn they're going to play the spider. They might shuffle away the spider with the Promising Vein if they don't need to. Also, or they're going to chump here with the... Oh, but it has trample, so that doesn't really even work. I don't know. Well, maybe they chump with the snail. No, they're going to trade here. Okay. Because assuming this trade happens, Waylaying Pirates means next turn especially since I'm about to get another treasure here, I can go pirates, tap your big blocker, load up equipment. Oh, another chance. Gross. Never mind. We're in big trouble because now they're going to get back the Chupacabra and the Sentinel, or maybe the rampaging thing. But yeah, Chupacabra, Sentinel. Yeah, this game's going to be a lot harder. Oh, they're playing Sentinel first? Oh, okay. That actually helps me quite a bit. Okay, and... Oh, no. All right. This continues to be more difficult than I would have liked. All right, let's just go waylaying pirates. Tap down your Sentinel. And... I guess I'd rather equip the Scallywag here and not get an extra treasure and just get a loot. I actually get two loots, which is nice. All right. Draw a card and discard a card. And then... Oh, I guess I actually should have done it the other way around. Discard... Puzzle door, yeah, I will discard puzzle door. All right, that is better. But I should have still done it the other way around so I would have more information about what to loot away. They sacked the Promising Vein? Are they crazy? They shuffled away their Eternal Witness. Okay. Well, that made me more likely to win, that's for sure. And then I get another treasure end of turn. Because now they can Chupacabra, but like I guess kill the Scallywag, but I still get another turn of good attacks, and then I get to play the Merfolk Scout. I guess now they have 7 mana, so they can play this and something else. But shuffling away the Scavenger for a land that you didn't need is just an absurdly bad play, to be honest. So that gives us a little chance, because I didn't think I was beating the Chupacabra coming back again, but yeah, maybe we won't face that. Still could very much lose this game, but basically them choosing to draw a random card instead of a 3-2 that gets back any creature is pretty good for me. Oh, they made a 5-5 plus a 3-3. I don't love that. Okay, well. Equip. Equip. Attack. Make a treasure token. Draw, discard. Okay, and I actually have to wait a turn on playing this Waterwind Scout. I can't play it this turn, because in order to win this game, I really need them to Chupacabra, not the Waterwind Scout. The Waterwind Scout, because if I can go Waterwind Scout, put my 2 equipment, put my Atali's Favor on, I could definitely win. Jade Seedstones, the kits keep coming. I am still don't think I'm going to win this game, but who knows. And then Chupacabra down my Scallywag. Yeah, we're pretty dead. Them playing this also means they can next turn craft it and gain 7 life. Oh, well. Take 10 here. Draw. I mean, that is a good card. I have 8 mana. I think I'm going to Atali's Favor this, because I think this is one of the ways we maybe have a mild chance. All right, Shipwreck Sentry, not super exciting. Wailing Pirates, tap down Sentinel, and attack with the Wander Glyph. Yep, trade, take 1, and I don't really need to equip. I can just double block here. Don't really know what I can draw to get out of this at this point. I really like this deck, but we are getting demolished. Yeah, I mean, Chupacabra Echo is just a sick card. They played it. They got it back. They could have gotten it back again. And Sentinel of the Nameless City is also a very, very strong card. So did end up... I guess this is the game where I went equipment into Plundering Pirate. I needed to like have a 2-draw maybe, but... I would keep that same hand again. And I did like the way this deck played out. The Atali's Favor equipment pirate deck was pretty sweet. It just I don't know, needed things to break a little bit differently, I think. The Waylaying Pirates were pretty excellent in this deck, too. All right, gain your seven. And then map token that. And yeah, I mean, I will double block, and then I'm facing down a 6-7 and a 7-7, huh? Yeah, once the game gets to this point, it's pretty hard for my deck to win. I kind of need to be on the front foot, not the back foot. Which this deck has a lot of cards that lets it do that, but another pirate hat is not going to do the trick, and now we're at double chump. All right, well, you know, sometimes things don't quite work out. Let me take a look at this deck, though. I did like this deck. I had higher hopes for it, which, yeah, then Magic's tough. Don't always win. Trust me. I would like to win more than I do, and I've done all right. Oh, the Belligerent. I got to go off one time with it. That was cool. Yeah, I mean, look, you've got double Tomb Raider, double Shipwreck Sentry, Oaken Siren, bunch of Itali's Favors, Belligerent Wailing Pirates. I guess if I had, like, one more Oaken Siren, one more Tomb Raider over, like, Puzzle Door and Volatile Wanderglyph, this deck would be a lot smoother. But, yeah, I mean, I never drew Siren for a turn two play. And, you know, like a double Tomb Raider draw. Those are the kind of things I was hoping for. But I like this deck. I would draft it again. All right, well, thanks for watching. Sorry we didn't win more, but you know what? There's always a next time. That's what makes Magic great. I enjoyed playing out this deck and would have just liked to rack up another win or two. As always, you can get any card you need from tcgplayer.com. And of course, head on over to Ultimate Guard. Go to ultimateguard.com. Check out what they have to offer as well. All the best sleeves, deck boxes, accessories you can ask for. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.